Using the priority list T2, T1, T3, T5, T7, T4, T6, schedule the project below with two processor. So this is our priority list, and this is the diagram we have given. And now we want to schedule the project using two processor. So first of all, let's copy this priority list down here. T2, T1, T3, T5, T7, T4, and T6. These are the tasks we need to complete, and this is the order of our priority. So whenever we have the priority, it doesn't mean that all of them are available in our order. So what we need to do is to make the schedule, we need to follow the list processing algorithm. So this is the list processing algorithm. It says on the diagram or the priority list, circle all the tasks that are ready, meaning that all the prerequisite tasks have been completed. So you can see that this is the priority list, and this is the diagram. By looking this diagram, you can see that T1, T2, and T3, you can see that in these vertices, there are no arrows coming from anywhere else. So that means T1, T2, and T3, they are available right away. So just circle them, T1, T2, and T3. So these are the three tasks already available. So to make the schedule, always draw this one, the time scale. And then depending on how many processor you have available in this problem, they're asking us to make the schedule with two processor. So I'm using P1 for the processor one and P2 for the processor two. And now I have to make this kind of a schedule. This is how we make the schedule. So starting time zero. So I'm going to make a time scale in the interval of 5, 5, 10, 15, and 20, 25, and we can keep going like this. So here we have given tasks and then the time required to finish the tasks. This time might be in the days or maybe in the hours. We don't have given any units here, so we are just taking it as a number, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and keep going until you finish the tasks. So according to the list processing algorithm, first of all, we have to circle all the available tasks, and these are the three tasks available. Go to the step two, assign to each available processor in order. So don't forget that you have to assign these available tasks to this processor in order. Mark the tasks as in progress, perhaps by putting a single line through the task. So here in this priority list, T2 comes first. So I'm going to assign T2 to the first one, and T1 to the second one. So I can see that from this diagram, to complete the T2, it takes 7 days. So in this time scale, 5, 6, 7, maybe this is the 7, it takes 7 days. And for the T1, it takes 5 days. So T2 is, busy with the, sorry, P1 is busy with the T2, and P2 is busy with the T1. So that's up to step two. Now go to the step three for the list processing algorithm, and you can see that move forward in time until a task is completed. Mark the task as a completed, perhaps by crossing out the task. So here you can see that on day 5, task one will be completed, so we just have to cross it. Now, on the very same step, you can see here, if any new tasks become ready, mark them as such. So you can see that after finishing T1 here on the diagram, immediately right after that, T4 will be available. Make sure that T5 is not available until now, because to become this T5 available, you need to finish T2 as well. So by looking this diagram, you can see that T1 is done. And by doing that, T4 will be immediately available on this list. So now step four for the list processing algorithm, it says repeat until all the tags have been scheduled. So we need to use the very same step, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and repeat it until we cross all the available tags here. So you can see that this is our priority and there are two tags available, T3 and T4. So first available tags, we're going to assign to the first available processor. So you can see that on day 5, processor P2 will be available. So I'm going to assign that T3 to the processor P2. And I know for the T3, it takes 9 days. So 9 plus 5 is 14. And then as we move forward on this time scale, we can see that on day 7, this T2 will be done. So now we can just cross it, completed. And we just have to go back to the diagram here and we can see that if T2 is done, then T5 will be available because T1 is already done. So this T5 will be available. So now we have the updated list here. So still processor 2 is busy with the T3, but processor P1 is free now. So we're going to see which available task in the priority list comes first. So we can see that T5 is available and it comes first in the priority list. So we're going to assign this P2 to T5. And we know that T5 takes 4 days. So 7 plus 4 is 11. So we can see that on 11 days, while P2 is still busy with the TT, T3, T5 will be completed. So now after T5 is done, we can see that there won't be anything available because that won't help to make this 7 and 6 available, because for that we need to finish 4 and 3, but still we have not finished 4. So now next available task is T4. So we're going to assign this T4 to the available processor P1. So for T4, it takes 10 days. So 11 plus 10 is 21. So we can see that processor P2 will be done with the T3 on day 14. So on day 14, T3 will be done. So after T3 is done, we can see that it won't help you to make this T7 available, because for T7 to be available, T4 also should be done, but T4 is still in progress. So now there's nothing available to assign for the P2, so we have to make this P2 idle. So there is nothing available. For how long? From 14 to 21 this day. So you can see that this time, because T2, T5, T4 gives you the 21. So on 21 days, this T4 will be done. So now after T4 is done, you can see that 6 and 7 will be immediately available. So 6 and 7, because we can see that 3, 4, and 5, they are done. So 6 and 7 will be available. But in the priority list, we can see that 7 comes first. So we are going to assign 7 to the first processor and then 6 to the second processor. And for the 7, it takes 3 days. So 21 plus 3 is 24. And then for 6, it takes 12 days. So 21 plus 12 is 33. So maybe this is 30. And this is 35. So this is 33. So here you can see that processor P1 will be done with the T7 on 24 days. So rest of the day from 24 to 33. It has to be ideal. So this is the complete schedule for this project. If we try to use the two processor with this priority list. So you can see that now you can answer any of these questions using this schedule. So here, if we go back here, we can see list the tax number of the tax processor one works. So we can see that processor one is working on T2, T5, T4, T7. And then we just have to, you know, use numbers for those tags. So the answer for this one you have to put is 2, 5, 4, 7. And that is our complete work. So finally, T6 and T7 all of them are done. So you can see that all the taxes on the priority list, they are done. And this is the complete schedule.